This is the hood. This is the epicenter of it all.
Hundreds descended on Del Ridge Skate Park today to pay tribute to the man who literally paved the way.
He would draw out these drawings that just looked like, they looked like acid trips. And they were skate park designs. And he said, someday.
Longtime friend Marshall Reed says Hubbard had many nicknames, but Monk was his favorite.
He legitimately changed skateboarding forever. He always wanted to do something bigger, build something bigger, go bigger, drive farther.
When plywood half pipes wouldn't do, Monk moved to concrete bowls in the late 1980s, learning along the way.
There's nowhere to go to school or there's nowhere to go train for that because nobody's doing it at the time, you know.
Micah Shapiro is the lead designer at Grindline, the skate park company founded by Hubbard.
You know, it's like I work on these all day long, but like if you would have asked me in 1988, hey, show me a picture of that, my mind would have been exploded. It would just exploded because I wouldn't be able to fathom like what that is.
What started in West Seattle spread all across the country with hundreds of Grindline skate parks now serving those who enjoy being a little different.
And I think that is kind of the thing about skateboarding. There's no rules really. I mean, you got a piece of wood and four wheels and you just do whatever you enjoy out of it is what you do.
Monk once said, skate parks are an asset to the community where kids can go and families can go and watch people roll around on the earth. It's always been a spiritual thing. Skating for Monk and many here is truly a religion with followers of all different backgrounds, ages, and colors.
Whether they're from, you know, 8 years old to 48 years old, everybody's skating together, having a good time.
Carrying on Monk's concrete legacy. In West Seattle, Greg Copeland, King 5 News.